Hello everyone, here is lecture 4 on semiconductors. In this lecture we have to see the law of mass action, charge neutrality condition, effect of temperature on Fermi level in extrinsic semiconductor, effect of variation of impurity concentration on Fermi level. Let's see the first one, law of mass action. It states that the product of electrons and holes in intrinsic or in extrinsic semiconductor is always constant. Like in n-type we have the product of majority charge carrier electrons and holes is constant. Similarly in p-type semiconductor we have this equation. Let's start to talk about the intrinsic semiconductor. As we know, in intrinsic semiconductor the concentration of electrons is expressed by this equation, where Nc represents to the effective density of states in the conduction band and holes p is expressed by this equation, where Nv represents to the effective density of states in the valence band, Ef be the Fermi level, Ev be the top of valence band, K Boltzmann constant, T represents to temperature. In the previous one, Ec represents to bottom of conduction band, Fermi level. Since in intrinsic semiconductor, the number of electrons is equal to the number of holes, so both can be equivalent and again it can be represented by a common term, Ni. Subscript I represents to intrinsic nature. When we multiply N and P, we have Nc, Nv and exponential. The Fermi terms will be cancelled out and we will have exponential minus Ec minus Ev upon kT. In other words, exponential within a bracket Ec minus Ev means Eg, and minus is was there, so minus is kept here, so minus Eg upon 2kT. Since Ec minus Ev, Ec minus Evc is equal to Eg, and why 2 is here, since the product will be expressed by Nc and V and exponential minus Eg upon kT. But on the left side we have N into P. When N and P are replaced by Ni, then we will have Ni square. So when square is removed, we have square root of Nc and V, and the exponential term will be divided by 2. So we have the concentration of electrons equal to this one and concentration of holes equal to this one in terms of forbidden energy gap. When we talk about an extrinsic semiconductor, means n-type, this equation will be replaced by this one, where left hand side previously it represents to concentration of electrons. Now the concentration of electrons which are majority charge carrier in n-type semiconductor, those are represented by Nn, where subscript small n represents to n-type and n represents to electrons equal to this one already shown here. Similarly, this one will be transformed to this one, holes in n-type equal to this one. By multiplying both equations, we have on the left side this one, on the right side this one. We have discussed while talking about these equations, so we have this one. And since n into p equal to ni square, according to this one we obtained ni square, or in other words the right side, this one, see, according to this one, if it is squared, on the left side we will have ni square and on the right side ncnv exponential minus eg upon kt. means this term is equal to ni square. Okay, if you see on the left side, if nn is increased, then pn will be reduced. Depending on the doping concentration, okay, to how extent manner it is increased, that can be discussed. If it is increased by a small number, then it will be reduced by that small number. As a product, we have a constant always. Okay, it represents to the law of mass action. Applying this equation to p-type, we will have ppnp at place of n. Okay, for p-type we will have p at the subscripts. So, and the majority charge carrier in p-type are holes, so pp, and the minority charge carriers are electrons, means n electrons, p-type. So majority and minority charge carriers product is constant. So this is known as law of mass action. When the impurity concentration is high, then it will be high. Then the minority charge carriers will be smaller. Okay. So finally we will have constant. Moving to next. These points have already been discussed in previous slide. Now, for next topic, charge neutrality condition. See, neutrality is used here. Means neutral material. Neutral means the total negative charge must be equal to the total positive charge. In that case, that will be neutral. In an extrinsic semiconductor or an intrinsic semiconductor also. First of all, let's talk about intrinsic semiconductor. We know that the number of electrons released from the valence band, okay, in other words transformed to the conduction band, are equal to the number of holes produced in the valence band. And the charge of a hole is equal to the charge of an electron. Okay, so total negative charge in the conduction band will be equal to the total positive charge in the valence band. As a result, we have a neutral intrinsic semiconductor. There is no resultant charge. Both will be cancelled out to each. Okay, when we talk about an extrinsic semiconductor, n-type or p-type semiconductor, as we know, to see this figure, it represents to n-type semiconductor. This is a donor level. So when an electron is donated by a donor, okay, so negative charge is produced in the conduction band and a positive charge is produced in the donor level. Okay, when here in this figure there are 5 donor atoms, when all are ionized, we have 5 electrons in the conduction band and 5 immobile atomic positive ions in the donor level. So 5 electrons negative charge, 5 positive charge, both are equal, means neutral. If we provide excess amount of temperature, okay, which provides an energy to an electron to jump from here to here, okay, then a covalent bond is broken and an electron is jumped to conduction band. Then the total number of electrons are 6. But here a hole is produced of charge is equal to charge of an electron. Okay, but here it is a positive charge. So 6 electrons, okay, 6 negative charge. And see, one hole means positive charge, one positive charge and 5 positive charge. So total positive charge is equal to the total negative charge. So in n-type semiconductor, total negative charge is expressed by nn. N means electrons in n-type. And total positive charge of a donor level is equal to ND. Okay, means it represents to the number. Okay, not representing to the charge. If you multiply by 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, with each term we will have a charge. But the total number of donor atoms means positive charge, and total number of holes means in N type P represents to number of holes PN. So this is positive charge in the donor level. Okay, number of immobile atomic ions, and it represents the positive charge also in the valence band. Okay, if you multiply on the right hand side by 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, we have a total positive charge, and by multiplying on the left hand side we have total negative charge. So both will be equal, as we have discussed. If there are 6 electrons here, 5 here and 1 hole is here, so total 6 positive charge particles are here, whether they are donor or holes. And total negative charge particles means electrons in conduction band. So it is applied for N-type semiconductor. But talking about the P-type semiconductor, by accepting an electron from the valence band, accepting atom is becoming a negative immobile atomic ion by producing a hole. So if there are 5 acceptor atoms, so we will have 5 holes. Okay, after ionization. Okay, and all 5 will be transformed into 5 negative ions, 5 holes will be here. If excess amount of temperature is provided, due to which electron can jump from here to here, okay, then electron will be produced, negative charge. The same amount of positive charge will be produced here. Total number of acceptor ions and electron. Okay, see, total number of acceptor ions and electron is equal to the total number of positive charges. See, 5 negative and 1 negative in conduction, means there are 6 total negative particles. Okay, whether acceptor or electron, and here 5 holes will be here. Okay, due to ionization process, and by jumping of electron from here to here, 1 hole is further produced. So total 6 holes are in valence band. Again, total positive charge is equal to the total sum of the negative charge of acceptor ions and electrons. So see, same acceptor ions, electrons in P type, total negative ion, and on the left side total positive ions. Since in N type semiconductor the donor concentration is very high in the minority charge carriers. Okay, if these are in the power of 10 power 24, these are in 10 power 10, so very less, means it can be neglected. If it can be neglected, then PP will be equivalent to Na. Okay, and when it is neglected, then NN will be equivalent to ND. So when NN equal to ND, by following law of mass action, this one, if NN equal to ND, we will have PN equal to Ni square upon ND. Similarly, Ni square upon Na, since PP equal to Na, so NP equal to Ni square upon Na. See, with the help of these equations, we can determine the concentration of minority charge carriers in the N type. See, the subscript is N, means N type, and P in P type. So with the help of charge neutrality condition, we can determine the concentration of minority charge carriers in extrinsic semiconductor. Next, let's see two numerical problems based on previous discussion. In this numerical, in a doped semiconductor, there are holes, 4.52 into 10 power 24 and 1.25 electrons. So concentration of holes is higher than electrons, means it is a p-type semiconductor. What will be the carrier concentration in undoped specimen? Undoped means if it was intrinsic before doping, okay, but here it is already given, there are holes and electrons. So with the help of that one, we know that from the law of mass action, we have Ni square equal to PpNp, so Ni will be equal to square root of these terms. So these are given, Pp is given, concentration of holes, and this one is given. Okay, with the help of that one, the concentration, intrinsic charge carriers, okay, of an intrinsic semiconductor can be known. See, an intrinsic semiconductor is, after doping, is transformed into an extrinsic semiconductor. So these terms are obtained in extrinsic semiconductor. But with the help of these terms, the concentration before doping, means Ni, is determined per meter cube. Again, electron and holes mobilities are this one and this one. So electron mobility is higher than holes mobility. Calculate the conductivity of intrinsic and the doped semiconductor, means p-type semiconductor. So for intrinsic semiconductor, the conductivity is expressed by this equation, as we have already discussed, sigma I equal to this one, by substituting the value of electron, Ni was determined with the first point, mu e, mu h, electron and holes mobilities are given here, substituted here. And after simplification, conductivity is equal to this one. Okay. In other words, Simon per meter. Or in other words, ohm inverse, meter inverse. Or mho upon meter, or mho meter inverse. So conductivity is this one. Okay. Again, the conductivity for doped semiconductor means, after doping, we have p-type semiconductor. To see this concentration, it can be concluded that after doping, we have p-type semiconductor. So again, we know that the conductivity of p-type semiconductor is expressed by EPP mu h, mobility of holes, majority charge carriers, electron charge, means positive charge will be taken here, okay, positron. Okay. So after substitution here, we have conductivity, okay, kilo Simon per meter. So higher conductivity is obtained after doping. See, in the initial stage we have 2.14 Simon per meter, but after doping we have 130, okay, into 10 power 3 Simon per meter. So 10 power 5 times is increased, okay. So because of, there is need to transfer intrinsic semiconductors to extrinsic semiconductors. In the next numerical, a sample of intrinsic germanium at room temperature has carrier concentration of this one, okay, Ni is given. It is doped with antimony, means pentavalent. One antimony atom per million atoms of germanium. So we have to calculate the concentration of antimony, means concentration of doping atoms. If the concentration of germanium atoms is given here, this one. So Ni, intrinsic charge carriers are given here, and doping concentration is given here. See, this it represents to the concentration of germanium atoms in a solid, and it is said that one antimony atom per million germanium atoms is doped. Okay. Per million germanium atoms. Germanium atoms are this one. So concentration of doping atoms will be equal to concentration of germanium atoms. One atom per million atoms of germanium. So 1 upon 10 power 6. So one atom is required for 10 power 6 atoms. Okay. So these atoms, for these atoms, how many donors will be required? So there is need to divide by 10 power 6. Okay. So Nd is obtained. So we have Ni and Nd. We have to determine the whole concentration. See, whole means in N type holes. So these are minority charge carriers. So Pn. So Pn equal to Ni square upon Nn. From the law of mass action, and by substituting the values of, we have Pn equal to this one. So by following a given condition, we determine Nd, and with the help of Nd and Ni, we have this one. Let's see the effect of temperature on Fermi level. At zero temperature, or at 0 degree Kelvin, okay, in other words, at very low temperature, Fermi level of N type is located in between EC and ED, donor level and conduction band, conduction bottom of a conduction band, in between, when ionization is not started, okay, then Fermi level is located in between these two levels. So donor atoms are waiting to provide their pentavalent electron, okay, to the conduction band. But for that one, the temperature equivalent to this difference will be required. When the temperature equivalent to this difference is provided, then electrons start to jump from donor level to conduction band. Since the concentration of electrons will be increased in the conduction band by gradual increase in temperature, so because of that, Fermi level will be shifted downwards, since it represents to the probability of an energy level to be occupied, okay, must be 0.5 or 50%, okay. So above levels must be 50% filled, and lower levels must also be 50% filled. So it always tries to maintain that condition. And as well as we know that at intrinsic temperature or for an intrinsic semiconductor, Fermi level is in between EC and EV. So as we have discussed, during the increase in the temperature, ionization of donor levels is occurred. So this, the concentration gradually increased in the conduction band. Okay, concentration of electrons will be increased in the conduction band gradually. It has been discussed in the previous lectures. So this region is called tilt ionization region, tilt to depletion temperature. Okay, this region, ionization. At this temperature, all donors will have been ionized by donating electrons to conduction band. So no further donor atom will be available to donate further electron. So because of this is called depletion temperature. There are no electrons here to provide to conduction band, but electrons are here. But to jump from here to here, this amount of energy, the gap between EC and EV, will be required. Means there is need to increase the temperature, so temperature is gradually increased till to Ti. So till to Ti, the concentration of electrons is constant, so this is called depletion region, depleted totally, means no further electrons are jumping to conduction band, and this donor level is depleted, so it is constant. But after attaining Ti, means when this amount of energy will be provided, then covalent bonds will be broken from the valence band and electrons start to jump to the conduction band. When this process is occurred, okay, is known as intrinsic process, and the temperature at which it starts is known as intrinsic temperature, and the region is known as intrinsic region. We have already been seen that at depletion temperature, Fermi level will be coincided to the donor level. Okay, intrinsic region means material start to behave like as an intrinsic semiconductor. because of that Fermi level must be in between EC and EV, means Fermi level equal to EFI, since EFN, FN is transformed into FI. Okay, entire semiconductor is transformed into intrinsic semiconductor. So Fermi level will be expressed by EFI, and that will be equal to EG by 2. EG by 2 means that will be located at the middle after TI. See, at zero temperature it is in between EC and DT. At high temperature after 350 Kelvin, okay, it is around 370 degree Kelvin. So it must be here. Okay, means Fermi level initially was here, but after TI it must be here. Means there is gradual shift towards the center. So by gradually increasing the temperature, Fermi level gradually shifts downward, and at depletion temperature will be coincided to the donor level. See, Fermi level will be equal to energy of donor level, and at TI Fermi level, okay, will be equal to EG by 2, means it will lie in the middle. So in between TD and TI, due to increase the temperature, it gradually reduces or shifts downward, and after TI it will always be in the middle. So by increasing the temperature, Fermi level is gradually shifting towards the bottom side and finally is locating in the middle. So this curve represents the variation of Fermi level in n-type semiconductor. Similarly, in p-type semiconductor, Fermi level previously located in between acceptor level and top of valence band, and the same process, by increasing the temperature, electrons start to jump to acceptor level and acceptors becomes saturated one by one. Okay, when all become saturated, then the temperature is called saturated temperature, not TD. Okay, saturated temperature. At this temperature, Fermi level will be coincided to the EA. Fermi level will be coincided or equal to EA. But after increasing further temperature, no further acceptor available to accept electrons, which is jumping or transformed to the valence band to this level, since all have been saturated by accepting an electron. But there is a chance to jump electron from valence to conduction band. When this amount of energy is obtained, then electrons start to jump to conduction band. Then semiconductors start to behave like as an intrinsic semiconductor. And the temperature, when it occurs, intrinsic temperature. So this temperature region is called depletion region. Sorry, not depletion, saturated region. This is ionization region, this is saturated region, and from after TI will be intrinsic region. At intrinsic region, Fermi level will be located in the middle. So because of, by increasing the temperature, it starts to shift towards middle. Okay, see, these points have already been discussed. Let's see p-type and n-type semiconductors at 0 degree Kelvin and 300 degree Kelvin. This is an energy band diagram. As we have seen that at low temperature, 0 degree Kelvin, Fermi level lies between conduction band and donor level. Okay, in between. See, just it is drawn. We don't have to show the variation. It is at constant temperature, fixed temperature. So in the middle. At 300, see, at 300, okay, this level, okay, will be in the middle of ED and EFI, in the middle here. It is shown little further shifted downwards, but it will be located in the middle. what? EFN will be located in the middle of ED and EFI at 300. At 370, it will be in the middle of EC and EV. But at this temperature, in the middle of ED, see this one and this one. So ED and EFN in the middle. Middle level is known as intrinsic Fermi level because of it is represented as EFI. And here this Fermi level represents to extrinsic semiconductor Fermi level because of it is EFN. So at 300 Kelvin, it is located in the middle of ED and EFI. Similarly, in P-type, at 0 degree Kelvin, it will be in between EA and EV, as we have discussed. It will also be in the middle of EA and EFI at 300 degree Kelvin. Here, see, at this temperature, Fermi level lies in between EFI and EA. Okay, in between these two levels here. See, EFI and EA in between. Next, we will see the effect of impurity concentration. So these points will be discussed in the figure. Figure A, it represents that the donor concentration is very low, around 2-3 donor atoms are here, okay, which are represented by a donor level. So in other words, this level may be comprised of 2-3 levels or states, okay. So not need to be shown as a band, so it is represented as a single energy level, ED. Okay, the forbidden energy gap is equal to the difference of EC and EV. The difference between these two levels, EV and EC, is called forbidden energy gap. And the Fermi level is located in between EC and ED at very low temperature. So we are discussing at very low temperature. So this one is located in between these two levels. Let's see, when the concentration of donor levels, means impurity atoms, is increased, then a single level will be transformed into a band according to the concentration of impurity atoms. Okay, so single level energy level or donor energy level is transformed into a band on the basis of the width of donor level. Okay, Fermi level is shifted towards EC. See, the gap is little higher here in figure A, but the gap is reduced when this one ED is transformed into a band. Here many energy levels are exist. Okay, since the concentration of impurity atoms is increased. Again here the gap will be same, EC minus EV. But when the impurity concentration is very high, then this sharp band will be converted into a broader band. And band is also shifted in the conduction band. As a result of that, this Fermi level is shifted in the conduction band. So the width of ED restricts to Fermi level to shift towards EC and finally into its band. Okay. So it represents to the variation of Fermi level or shifting of Fermi level relative to the concentration of impurity atoms. See. Okay. So these figures are only focused on impurity concentration. Okay. What will happen if impurity concentration is increased? Then Fermi level is gradually shifted towards the conduction band. That's all in this lecture. Thank you. Thank you all.